Today we're going to talk about how to install a optical sensor on the BigTreeTech SKR Pro version 1.1. So I need to point out a couple of things real quick. First of all, we have our end stops over here. So to start with, we have our X-min, our Y-min, our Z-min, our X-max, our Y-max, and our Z-max. Inside here, each one of these shares the same type of pins. So starting with the one on the far corner, that's our voltage. Then we have our ground. Then we have our signal. So let me point out on the optical sensor right here, we have our voltage, our signal, our ground. So this takes a special type of cable, where you can see that it has a notch connector that fits in it. And what I've done is I've traced out on the notched connector where the colors correspond to each color. So as you can see here, we have our red, which is voltage. We have our blank, which is signal. And then we have our ground. So to connect this, what we're going to do is we're going to connect first voltage, then we're going to connect our ground, and then we're finally going to connect our signal. Now, in order to load this with firmware on the BigTreeTech SKR Pro version 1.1, we need to use a microSD card. So I'm going to remove this card from here from the TF drive and place it inside the micro SD adapter. I'm then going to place that in a computer and you're going to hear a beep. Okay, to start with, as we can see, the SD card is inserted in the computer and we have a file called firmware. Now it thinks it's the form of the type cursor, when actually it's just our current firmware. So what we're going to do is we're going to go over to Atom with PlatformIO loaded, and I need to tell you a couple of things. First of all, inside here we have the bug fix 2.0x by Marlin, that in order to do this, you need to download the marlin-bugfix.2.0.x and then unzip it. After you've unzipped it, you're going to have to go to File and open the folder for marlin-bugfix-2.0.x, and you'll have this. Now, in order to actually load the firmware, we're going to go over to the source folder, the core folder, and we're going to open up boards.h. Inside boards.h, we're going to do a search on SKR_pro, and the actual board definition that we're looking for is board_BigTree_SKR_Pro_V1_1. We're going to copy that, then we're going to close out of boards.h. Next, we're going to go over to configuration.h, and we're going to do a search on motherboard. And what we have here is the current board definition that we're not using, so we're going to replace that with what we paste over it here, which is board_BigTree_SKR_Pro_V1_1. Next, we're going to scroll up, and for define serial_port0, we're going to change the 0 to a -1, and then what we're going to do is we're going to do a search on endstop. And what we have here currently is our endstops that we're using. So we have the X-min, the Y-min, and the Z-min. But we can enable other ones if we so choose, like if we wanted a second X max or maybe Y max or Z max by removing the comment. So we're going to do the Z max probe over here, even though we're using X minimum. And down here we have something for endstop pull-ups. This will allow you to adjust or smooth out a float point situation with the state of your endstop, but I'll let you experiment with that on your own. And then down here we have inverting. Now sometimes when we use an endstop, what happens is the signal comes out the opposite of what we want. And in the case of the optical endstop, we're not sure if it's going to be showing up as triggered or if it's going to show up as open. So what we're going to do is we're going to change just this one endstop to true and see what happens. If it's incorrect on your own, you can go back and change it back to false. But if it's true, then you'll know what to do when it happens. So next thing that we need to do is configure our actual PlatformIO.ini. And inside here, what you see is it says default ENVs. That's default environment. That's the board chipset that we would be working with. But the Mega AT Mega 2560 is not our board's chipset. So we need to search on it. So it's SKR underscore Pro. And as you can see, it says BigTree underscore Pro, or excuse me, BigTree underscore SKR underscore Pro. We're going to copy that, and then we're going to page up, and we're going to replace our default environment right here. So we're going to paste that. Now, in order to compile, we're going to click this checkbox and then save. Okay, now that the compilation has finished, we're going to go to PlatformIO, and then we're going to go to Toggle Build Panel. And what we see right here is it says one succeeded in almost 3 minutes. So we're going to scroll up here, and it looks like our board succeeded, so we're good there. So we're going to toggle the build panel. And in order to load the firmware, we have to first find it. So we're going to go to .pio, and we're going to expand that folder. Then we're going to expand the build folder, and then the big tree folder we're going to right click on, and we're going to say show in Explorer. So we're going to open it up over here, and we're going to go to the subfolder, and here's what we're looking for, firmware.bin. So we're going to right click on that, and we're going to say send to SD card, and then we're going to click on the SD card, and sure enough, it's there. So we're going to remove the micro SD adapter from the computer. Okay, now that we have the SD card removed from the computer, we're going to take the TF card out of it, and we're going to place it inside the drive for the BigTreeTech SKR Pro. And what we want to do is we want to make sure that we have this pin and this pin jumped, so that we can use 5 volts. And next what we're going to do is we're going to insert the large side of the serial USB into the connector here. And then we're going to take the other side and we're going to connect it to the computer, and you're probably going to hear a beep. And you notice the flashing in the center, that's the loading of the firmware. We're in the print run directory for Pronterface. So what we want to do is we want to click on Pronterface to open up the executable, connect to the printer. As you can see, the printer says that it's online. So we're going to type M119 for the G code to check the status of the end stops. And as you can see, they all say triggered. Now, the reason that the X-Min says triggered, because it's connected, is because earlier, when we were in the Marlin firmware, we inverted the actual output. So, normally it would say open without the changing the false to a true. So, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to place a piece of paper between the end stop for the optical sensor. Now watch the light. Notice how it goes out. So we've tripped the end stop. So let's press enter on M119 again and see what we get. And now it says open. So if we remove the paper, the light goes back on. And when we type M119, press enter again, it says triggered. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.